Good mythical morning, America. Doing a coffee time with Cobra, and oh look, the circus is here in town. Just kidding, guys. It's the local. Yes, I am actually. It's a local rodeo thing going on, and the wind. Jesus Christ! Could you stop farting for 5 minutes, Danka? Well, the tree that we thought is dead is not dead because it's starting to bloom. So that's actually bad news. But we are cutting that tree down. This tree is not blooming whatsoever, so it is dead. That tree is not blooming whatsoever, so it is dead. And that tree is not blooming whatsoever, so it is dead. So these three trees must go before termites and hornets and whatnot say, hey, nice, you know. So pretty much I threw out an SOS to some friends who have chainsaws to try and get a chainsaw from them. Yes, I did shave. I don't know, I look like my dad. To all my family members that do watch these, and I know some of my family have started watching my vlogs. I know, I look like dad, ready? Now I look like him even more when I smile. I know. To my brother Scott, buddy, I love you. I really do, mate, I love you. I hope you enjoyed your trip to London. So yay. And today is actually a Han day. It's a good day. Reason being is I just did a video for my old YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/Malevictus, M-A-L-V-I-C-T-U-S. It's my modeling channel, where I decided to get back into doing some miniature painting. It's one of the things I used to love doing. I had a passion for it. I just... Get off on what?
The Paint Olympics.
The Paint Olympics? What about it?
I was telling them how they like to take knives and into their junk and shit, and they get off on it.
Today was a Han day, it's just turned into a Fet day.
Oh no.
Just that quick, thanks to that scruffy looking nerf herder. Anyway, guys, it's a good day, it's a nice day, a bit windy. But that's good because when a horse farts, trust me, you don't want to smell it. And so yeah, like I said, the horses are everywhere today. So what I might do is I might go for a little walk later and film some of the horses and whatnot, just for whatever reasons, you know, reasons.
Like the ones down there at the end of the...
Yeah, it's like the ones all the way down the end of there. But... Oh god, I'm gonna sneeze. I can feel it in my left nostril.
Back up. Move it.
Thank you.
I didn't do that. That was Sherry.
Just I'll let them all go.
I'll get them.
Or not.
I'll get them. I got food.
All right.
They'll come for food.
Boys! Come away from there now!
Or do you want me to just let the rest of them out?
No. We're at the Lemon Pledge.
I was trying to let Grim through, and the dogs decided to push past him.
He's big enough and ugly enough to let himself throw out of anywhere, except for a paper bag. Lacks the upper body strength, you know.
Does that kind of look like a bed?
This is so cute.
Oh, this is cool.
This is so cute that it quite literally is giving me diabetes.
Look, Tampa.
I don't care.
It's where Jenny's at right now.
Oh, good for them.
Scooby.
I don't care.
And then you get
anyway.
Picture. Nice.
It's cool. The spout actually moved.
Got him that time. So yeah, it's because it's a person.
Actually, no, it's animatronic.
It's this one's animatronics. This one is in live person.
Let's see that one.
Work it.
Meh.
Work it.
Anyway, so yeah, it's a fun day. You still have some donuts, I think.
Oh yes, I still have my donut, don't I?
Do we still have donuts?
I better have my donut still.
Opening a donut box with one hand is not good.
Yes. These are all your cinnamon twists.
I'll take this bit. Wow. Why?
They didn't get put in there.
Dry. That's okay. That's why I have coffee.
Come on.
That ain't how you get them in.
I worked yesterday.
Won't work now. Did you give him a treat? No? Then it won't work.
Oh, fuck off.
This will.
Assholes!
This will. Watch and learn. Come on, boys. Get your aunties in the house. Come on, boys. Boys. Go. Arrgh, these frickin' dogs.
Yoink.
Gonna whoop your ass. Go. 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 Go, Hammy. There we go. Now they're in, and I'm out in the middle of my garden. Yay! And the sun's shining, I can't see my face, so yay! But yep, welcome to the country, where there quite literally is more livestock than there are people. Yay! Messed up thing is, there's a chick over there in purple jogging. Probably just missed her. Yeah, she's just gone past that one there. She's my neighbour across the street. She's actually from England. And she actually got into an accident and broke her back. Yes, she broke her back 4 months ago, and now she's out jogging. You know what that is? British stubbornness. Oh, I'm sorry, you'll never walk again. Fuck you, I'm running. Or, you'll never play football again. Fuck you, I'll get prosthetic legs. You know? That's the typical British mentality. Lose an arm, fuck it, give me a cybernetic implant. Lose a leg, fuck it, give me an implant. Lose an eye, fuck it, give me a glass eye. You know? I admire her a lot. She's my neighbour across the street. She's from up north. She's a northern monkey. But I'm a southern shaddy bastard, so it's alright. You know, the next up thing is, the 10th Doctor. My wife absolutely adores the 10th Doctor. Why? Leather jacket, northern accent, I guess. Couldn't fucking tell you.
Who, David?
No, the one before David.
Eccleston.
Eccleston.
And everyone in that bloody show kept saying, well, why does he have a northern accent? Everywhere has a north. Exactly. Everywhere has a north. And I can prove that. When your penis is happy, what way does it point? North.
Northeast.
Coke dick? Damn, dude.
I don't get no complaints.
I bet you don't. Unless you're turning southeast. Then.
Point is.
Point is, everywhere has a north, including Gallifrey. Now, in the new Doctor Who, they're talking about doing a gender swap. I'm all for equality. Okay? I am. But no.
I think the whole gender swap everybody was talking about, they think it was going to be the Doctor. Wasn't the Doctor, because they're going back to a male master.
I know. But no, the point is, no. You fucked up Ghostbusters. You're not fucking up Doctor Who. What's next? An all-female A-team?
Don't give any fucking ideas.
Or an all-female Knight Rider? Or better yet, here you go. An all-female... Dun-da-da-da! Are you ready? An all-female Expendables. The only thing running out of ammo is the tampon dispenser.
Okay, I agree that women should get publicity and shit.
Yeah.
But come on. Ghostbusters is supposed to be guys.
Mm-hmm. But not
the
one.
Doctor is supposed to be a man,
yep.
Not a fucking woman.
But, see, that's the thing. They were testing the water when they made the Master a woman to see who would react. And you know what feminists did? they reacted bad to it because they wanted it to be the Doctor, not a B-roll hero like the Master. And now that's why the BBC are rolling him back to being a man. You see what I'm saying? Now, again, I'm an egalitarian. I believe in equality for everyone. Male, female, transgender, gay, straight, lesbian. I believe in equal rights for cats to dogs. I don't care. I believe that everyone should be limitless, okay? Which means everyone should have the ability to do whatever the hell they want as long as they don't hurt another person while doing it.
Yeah.
Okay? I'm simple. I'm an egalitarian. Fuck you, feminism, okay? Feminism is only about boasting the equality of woman to man.
Well, at least the new school fucking feminism. It's fucking bullshit.
Exactly.
Yeah, because my grandmother hates the new feminism.
Yeah.
She goes, that is not what we fought for.
Exactly.
That is not what we were all about.
Mm-hmm. Now, here's the messed up thing. Name the most woman-strict religion you can think of.
Muslims.
So why is third wave feminism sticking up for Islam?
Yeah, I know. Oh, that's all right. Excuse my language, but the bitches, because it's what they are, I don't give a fuck, and I'm looking at you, Anita Sarkeesian, you fucking cunt, actually went and in this one Facebook group, I seen screenshots of it, during the Trump protests up in Chicago, freaking told all the female protesters to wear fucking burkas, that way if anybody even bumped into them, they could be charged with a fucking goddamn religious hate crime.
Like I said, now, you guys know, if you don't know, I was baptized Catholic, okay? Do I preach God?
Mm-hmm.
No. Do I force my impeachment on others? No. Grim? Where it
I was raised a Jehovah's Witness and I went freaking pagan.
Missy here? Yeah.
Mormon.
Okay. Wife, Mormon. So, let me explain something to you. I've got Buddhist friends, I've got Judean friends, I've got Hindu friends, I've got Sikh friends, I've got freaking... Yeah, I've got friends in damn near every religion but Islam. Okay? Because even my friend, and that's the thing, there is such a thing as a Jack Muslim, you know? He was baptized Muslim, very similar thing. I'm basically a Jack Christian, okay? Last time I went to church was when my family members died. I don't go to church on a daily. Yes, I do have this. This is my father's. This was my father's father's and his father's before him. This is handed down from father to son. I'm the fifth bearer of this. And my daughter will be the sixth bearer of this. Because I don't have a son. But point is, I don't force any religion on anyone. And if your religion says you must kill someone who doesn't believe in what you believe, it's not a religion. That's a cult.
No longer a Mormon.
Well, it's not that, but every definition within what the ATF consider a cult, Islam actually strikes 11 of those 12 things.
I don't want one husband and 10 other wives.
Mm-hmm.
Hell, just look at fucking... Just go to the Southern Poverty Law Center and look at their freaking definition of a cult.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Muslims hit every single fucking goddamn mark.
Now, this isn't me Muslim bashing. Okay. It's not me Muslim bashing. Relax. Okay, relax, guys. Look,
I've got friends that are there Muslim, are good but they're Muslims. Not like the ones that are wanting to blow everybody to hell. Exactly. They don't go by that. They even say straight out, I don't go for that shit. And if I was to freaking see one that was deciding they were going to do that shit, I'd pull my goddamn sidearm and I'd put a bullet in their fucking head.
Like I said, there are good Muslims, there are bad Muslims. Okay, so I'm not bashing all Muslims, okay?
There's good Christians, there's bad Christians.
There's good Hindi, good Sikhs, bad Sikhs, but there's always good Buddhists.
That is true.
Exactly.
I have never seen a bad Buddhist.
No, no religion no, of right. peace.
Exactly. That's why I always say namaste. You know, that's my one of my Pakistani
but
friends.
What is namaste?
Namaste means peace to you.
But who else uses namaste?
The Buddhists.
Who else?
Hindus, Sikhs, and...
Druids.
Wiccans.
Pagans.
Like I said, it's all about the peace. Every religion... Now, this is the thing, okay? The reason why Muslims have this whole kill those who don't believe in you is because of the whole freaking Crusades. Okay? when the Christian church, the Christian church, not the English people, not white people, just the Christian faith, said, destroy Muslims. Okay?
Hell, they did the same thing to the freaking Druids.
Yes. Now, don't get me wrong. That was bad.
Then to the Jews.
Then it was Pope Benedict that started that crap. Well, anyway,
Benedict the 13th.
Long story short, okay, or short story long, guys, knock it off. All right, just knock it off before I tell your mums, all right? And they'll just come and smack you with a slipper. All right, seriously. Knock it the fuck off. Oh, now, a couple of days ago, it's now technically 4 or 5 days ago, so it happened on Monday, there was that horrible attack in Syria. Now, point is this, okay? I'm just going to throw some points out, do some free thinking, do some Googling yourself, okay? Everyone knows what a Reichstag is, okay? Reichstag is a building in Germany that got set fire by Nazis and they blamed it on the Jews, so yeah, Hitler could come to power.
They blamed it on a mentally disabled Jewish guy that actually was one of their janitors.
Yep. Long story short, false flag operation. That's what people call it in the military. We call it a Reichstag, okay? Now, I'm not saying the Syrian attack was a red flag. It was an inside job or anything, any shit like that. What I'm saying to you is simply this, guys. The moment that attack happened, and it was condemned by both the British Prime Minister, the American President, and the United Nations, I knew for a fact that there would be a retaliation. Depending on who retaliates, depends on who's going to get the backlash. Now, yep. Trump fired the first missiles, yes. Or technically, he fired a return missile because whoever in Syria did this, okay? Point is, it happened in Syria. It's Syria's, it is on Syria.
It's a Syrian civil war. It's freaking anti-Assad forces.
My point is this. How many Syrian rebels, Syrian refugees, have escaped Syria and gone to other countries?
Never heard of none.
Actually, England is full of them. France is full of them. Germany's full of them.
Germany actually kicked them out.
Italy, Spain, you know, all the surrounding countries are full of Syrian refugees, okay? Uh-huh. Technically, now they're refugees. Well, technically they're not because no war has been declared. It's a civil war, which means it's up to the United Nations to deal with this because all the surrounding countries, including Russia, also have trade agreements with the United Nations. If the United Nations actually gets off of its bureaucratic fucking arse and actually does its fucking job and says, hey, knock it off or I'm telling your mum and she's going to smack you with a fucking slipper.
You know they won't.
That's my point. This is why America said fuck it and fired the first set of missiles in. Now, I know for a fact, because I've seen some of the documents, that 54 of the 59 missiles hit their targets. The other missiles were destroyed upon impact, i.e. they just harmlessly detonate before they hit the targets, i.e. the target was destroyed and they sent a kill order to the missile because they didn't want any extra damage done, or the missile missed its targets completely, or it misfired. Now, don't ask me how I know, because I can't tell you. If I did tell you, there'd be a squad kind of black bag.
I'll just say this, do a Google search. There's satellite imagery that even shows. They report that, oh, we hit the airstrip. Mm-hmm. They didn't even touch the airstrip. The airstrip is still 100% intact. They didn't even hit the control tower. They hit around the fucking airbase.
Now, I don't care if they hit it or not or whatever, anything like that. Long story short, this is the problem with the chain of command. When someone all the way at the top barks an order, now I'll put it in a way that anyone can understand. If you've ever owned a pet, okay, why blame the feet for the actions a mouth does? If that makes sense. If a dog is barking, okay, and you tell it to shut up and it doesn't shut up, okay, why do you smack it on the arse? It's not the arse's fault. Is the dog farting? No, it's barking. You smack him in the chops, tell him to knock it off. Knock it off, you know? Point is, same thing here. Trump has said, screw it, we're going in. Even though all generals are saying, we don't want boots on the ground. We just want to make this a battle of attrition, which means it's going to be an air battle, which means just missiles, 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 missiles. Okay, problem with that is, one, some of those missiles have to be laser guided, which means you're going to have someone on the ground with a laser pointing at the target, which means there are boots on the ground. So your generals are talking out their ass.
Not to mention explain the news reports coming out of Russia that's got freaking live damn videos showing freaking U.S. freaking troop carriers going into Syria.
Now, again, this is the thing. I think that is the Reichstag for one reason. Those vehicles were those vehicles, American flag and strap it on a vehicle.
True.
You didn't see any combat unit marks on the side.
True.
So who's to say that it's not Russia posing as American forces? Again, the whole PR stunt. I posted this on Facebook, which was the moment they're gonna, there's gonna be backlash. They're gonna say, oh, they hit a school, or they hit a hospital, or they hit something, or all of a sudden, well, no, there's not gonna be boots on the ground. All of a sudden, video footage gets leaked of military units being moved carrying American flags. Here's a hint: most American units don't wave a red, white, and blue.
Nope.
They wave their unit markers.
Yep.
The only red, white, and blue they strap is on their arms.
And if there is an American flag on the freaking vehicles, usually they're black. Mm-hmm. They're just the black stripes and the black stars, with the stripes being the color of the vehicle.
So it's not that hard to buy a flag of, a, of an opposing nation.
And it could have been very well missed, too. I just thought of... We all know Al-Qaeda is already in that area. Mm-hmm. They've captured vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
They could have very well just said, hey, look, we're going to do this. We're going to fuck with them.
Like I said... I think, especially with the media over the presidential election, and again, guys, I don't care who you voted for. Trump, Bernie, whoever, doesn't matter. It's over and it's dealt with, okay? He's the commander-in-chief. He has been for 90-something days now, 93, 94 days. Point is simply this. Stop believing in what you're just told. Believe in what you see, believe in what you hear, and believe in what you learn. Do the research yourself. Don't just say, oh, well, this research paper that was published in 1983, are we in 1983? Is Ronald Reagan the president? No.
No, but I wish he was.
Now, here's a hint. How does a British guy know who president was in 1983?
Because you did your homework.
Exactly. Like I said, don't just get your news source from one channel, Fox, CNN, MSNBC, blah, 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 blah. You know.
I'm sorry, this is going to show my age, but I wish Ford, with all his problems, was
Ford.
Still fucking president.
Gerald Ford, yeah. Like I said, do yourself a favor. Do the research yourself. Don't just believe it from one source. Believe it from a whole bunch of different sources, guys. If five sources are all saying the same thing, then there's something right there. But if four of the five aren't, then what's the fifth one reporting? And then follow that. And if the five are reporting the same year. It's called minority reporting. Do some. And no, I'm not talking about Tom Cruise. Where's my minority report? It's up your ass, you fucking weirdo. You know, look, end of the day. Now, when it comes to the Syrian issue, and I'm going to call it an issue because it is an issue. Everyone goes, oh, it's for the gas and the oil and blah, blah, blah. Okay, here's a hint. Why do you think other nations attacked other nations? For example, why do you think the Vikings went on raids? To say, hello, it's me? No. They went on raids because they needed slaves for manual labor. They needed, you know, things for trade, i.e. furs, gold, yeah. Silver, jewelry. That's what I'm talking about. It's as America puts it, when we go in and we break your shit. And we break your shit so bad, it doesn't work ever again. And so you have to pay us to get your shit to work again.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much. Same thing here. If Assad does not step down, I know for a fact that there is going to be British vehicles, British troops, as well as others.
They're going to pull what they did to Gaddafi in Libya.
Now, again...
What they did is gone.
Again, a lot of people do compare it to Gaddafi, compare it to Saddam and the whole fucking false flag things. But that's the thing. A lot of people keep saying that the chemical weapons that were used were actually from the stockpiles that Saddam Hussein had.
Yeah, but where did he get all those?
Saddam, he grew it. He made his own.
But where did he get the knowledge to do it?
I don't fucking know. The internet.
From the U.S.
Probably. Like I said, at the end of the day, okay, when it comes down to it. My stance on the whole Syrian thing is it's fucked up, okay? Why are all these young, combat-effective young men abandoning their women, their children, and their homeland? Plain and simple, I'm sorry. It, like the whole Facebook thing, if war came to American soil, would you fight, yes or no? No fucking contest. Of course I would fight, but I wouldn't fight for America, and I wouldn't fight for the enemy side. I'd fight for my own reasons, my own reason being my home, my property, oh, and my life.
I'd fight for my kids.
See what I'm saying? You have a reason to fight.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily out of patriotism. It's not necessarily out of nationalism or whatever you want to call it ism. It has to do with the fact that stay to your own, keep to your own, protect your own.
Yep.
Okay? If someone comes for my shit, you better believe I'm going to fight them with every fiber of my being to the point where even my corpse will come back from the dead and I will bite the fuck out of them and start a zombie apocalypse. Alright? Why? Because I care for my shit. Okay? Plain and simple. That includes these little kittens.
We'll see what's up, man.
This little lady. That blob. Who I love. How you doing, Bob? But at the end of the day, the whole Syrian thing, here's a hint, guys. Stop turning tail and running. Okay? Yeah, I get it. To you, to some of you people, if not a majority of you people, Assad is a really bad guy. Okay? I get it. I do get it. So do yourself a favor. Stop running away. Stop running to another country. Turn around. Grab your gear. Go back to your homeland and fight for it.
Hey, let me put a little bug in here. Do some research on Assad. On Bashar Assad. He actually wasn't doing that bad of a freaking job. Everybody had free healthcare, free electricity, every fucking thing. The main thing that pissed everybody off in the fucking region that he was going to do the same exact thing that Iraq was going to do, the same thing that Saudi Arabia was going to do, the same thing Gaddafi was going to do in Libya, and that was drop the American dollar and go back to a gold standard.
England already does have a gold standard, so... Oh, and I don't like the new British pound coin.
I've seen it. Looks weird.
I don't even like the new notes. The new notes look like they belong in like a Mardi Gras parade, if you know what I mean. Like they've all seen one up close, like Linus.
And Luke.
Oh, shots fired.
Ouch.
But no, at the end of the day, guys, when it comes down to it, whole Syrian refugee thing, I'm sure, the whole Syrian refugee thing, in all honesty, dude, guys, stop turning tail. Go back home. Either fight for Assad or fight against Assad. Okay? If you don't want to fight, okay, if it's not within your religious belief to fight, go to another Muslim country. Don't go to a Christian country. Don't go to an atheist country. Don't go to another country and automatically demand that that country suits your needs.
You know what I don't get about it? Is why are the men turning tail and running and hiding like little bitches while their wives and their kids are still there?
Like I said, that's my whole point. It says a lot of that.
Hello? You ain't no fucking man if you're gonna run and leave your wife and your kids behind.
Or your mum, or your father, or your brothers, or
exactly.
Your sisters. Yeah.
You're a little pussy ass
bitch.
You can say the word bitch. Like I said, that's Leah's take on it. My take on it is simply this, okay? To some who are very skeptic and want the whole, you know, tighter immigration policies, I get that. You want to make sure that you and your own are safe.
Exactly.
Same thing with my house. Doesn't make me racist. Okay? Here's the thing. You can't be racist towards a religion. You can't. Most people say, well, what about Hitler and the Jews? Again.
Hitler just hated everybody.
Again. No, that's the thing. Judaism, like every other faith, incorporates every other skin tone. There's not just black Jews, there's not just white Jews, there's not just Chinese Jews, okay? Judaism is a religion, it's a form of faith. You cannot be racist towards a form of faith, okay? Plain and simple.
I am.
Because who's to stop that person from saying, oh, I'm changing my religion, I'm become atheist, or I've become whatever, okay?
The whole religion thing reminded me of something else with Bashar Assad. A lot of people don't realize this. He is the only Muslim president of a Muslim-run country that actually freaking put protections in place for people of other fucking religions within his country.
Mm-hmm. Now, let me get back to the whole faith thing, which is simply this. Okay, guys? America has its own cultures, okay? Do not come to this country expecting this country to bend over to your culture. If you like your culture, stay to your country. Enjoy your culture there.
Yep.
Do not enforce your culture onto another country. England is extremely British. And if you don't know what that fucking means, here's a hint. Go to an Imperial War Museum. There's plenty of them around England. Watch the footage of England being bombed to shit. Okay? And I'm not just talking about by the Germans, I'm talking about by the Irish. I'm talking about by every fucking country that's had a beef, with England. And then ask yourself, why? Why England has not only beat every fucking country we've had an issue with the exception of the colonies of the United States. We have quite literally won every fucking fight because you can't kill us. Now, most people say, well, what about when England went into Afghanistan? We didn't go into Afghanistan. Yes, we were in Afghanistan, but we didn't go into Afghanistan in order to take Afghanistan. We went into Afghanistan to go to Murbat. Okay? Now, Murbat was a shit show. And it was a shit show because of some of the commanders, plain and fucking simple. If you don't believe me, Google that shit. Just Google it, right? Just Google it. Long story short, England has won damn near every major conflict we've ever fucking been in.
Yep.
And there's a reason why. Because you can't fucking kill us. You may murder me, okay? You may kill my body. You may snuff out my life, but you will never kill my spirit. And my spirit is British. Plain and simple. My spirit is British. Same as England. Same as America. Where do you think America gets its whole America fucking spirit from? They get it from England. And that's another thing. New England, founded by the English. Louisiana and Canada, founded by the French.
Washington, D.C., still a fucking corporation owned by the British. Think I'm bullshitting.
Look the original 13 colonies.
Look at your IRS tax forms.
Look at Social Security. I think it was in 1989. You can actually find the actual papers.
Yeah, work this out. So many people say socialist programs don't work. Yeah? What the hell do you think Medicaid and Medicare is? Socialist program. What the hell do you think Social Security income is? Socialist program.
What do you think food stamps are?
Socialist program. Food banks. Socialist program. America. No. Like I said, stop looking at the thin veneer layer of what you think is a beautiful paint job on your car.
And stop believing everything that you're told on mainstream media because it's all fucking a shit show.
Look under the car and see the sheer level of rust and shit. Because what most people don't tell you is when you're driving a car, you're not driving it on the roof, you're driving it from underneath. So shit's going to bounce up and hit you in your undercarriage where you don't expect it. Anyway, this video has been going on far too long. This video was supposed to have been posted yesterday. Today's Saturday. This is supposed to be Friday's. And in all honesty, I just completely fucking brain farted it. And so here we are. So I'm going to upload this. We'll edit it a little bit and upload it. And so I look forward to seeing that today. Well, Saturday. Okay. If this video is aimed for Friday and it's going up Saturday, am I talking about Friday in the rep? Wibbly wobbly timey wimey. Later. Hey guys, good mythical morning America. Welcome to another Coffee Time with Cobra. And it's definitely a hard day today, baby. Oh yeah. Sun is shining, birds are singing, dogs are peeing and pooping apparently. And no, I'm not gonna film that, you pervs. So come away from the corner. Of course. What kind of video would this be without my brother?
So,
did a really interesting podcast last night. We did the first episode of the Kinkcast. Link to it will be in the video description down below if you want to check it out. FYI, it is not safe for work. Okay, it is a 21 plus rated podcast. We do talk about some taboo subjects. And if you're easily offended, do not click the link. If you're a special snowflake, prepared to get your fucking face melted off. That's all I need to say. But put like this, it's an interesting listen. It is an audio podcast, and there's no a video to it, like this one. And my pit bulls are going absolutely apeshit. Why are you attacking a tree, you dumb shits? Get out from, oh my gosh. Kids, away. Come on. You do know that Dad's filming this, right? Wait. Knock it off. Go. Dottie? Anyway, today is a interesting day. The things you find out about people, that's all I need to say. It is an interesting day. Go! It's always Monty and Hemi. Come on, you two! Anyway, so yeah, you know, guys, I'll end this bit and I'll see you in the next part of the coffee time. All right, we're back inside the house, guys, and I mentioned in one of my videos that I've yet to put up on one of my YouTube channels that I'm getting back into doing my modeling, and yeah, I am. They are literally taking over everywhere. Focus, you piece of shit. Focus. It never wants to focus. Really? There we go. Focus, you piece of turd. So I'm in the process of cleaning my equipment, testing stuff, and whatnot, and whatnot, and whatnot. So, yeah. Other than that, you know, things are going meh for me right now. Not too bad, not too great. Can't complain. And I'm in the middle of watching a Next Level Painting stream that I missed. So I'm catching up to you, Kenny Boucher. Amazing stuff that you do, brother. Really is. If you haven't checked him out already, guys, the links will be in the video description down below. Till then, guys, I will see you in the next Coffee Time with Cobra. Bye. Hey, guys, you know what day it is. And the battery's almost dead in this thing, so I better make this one a quick. It is Wednesday. It is 2 o'clock. I know, I've been slacking a little bit on the Coffee Times with Cobra, but welcome to Wednesday's Coffee Time with Cobra. Unfortunately, I don't have my Han and my Fett cup sitting in the sink. I've got to go wash it. And today's been an interesting day. It really has. I'm planning on getting ready to go live on Twitch. And I want to do some miniature painting on Twitch. But unfortunately, I can't, and the reason why is because I've got to pounce on this opportunity. Cotton Gamer, as much as I love him, isn't streaming HNG, so there's a high chance I can steal some of his viewers. I know it's horrible, but I got to get my view count up. I do. I'm currently still waiting to hear back about my Twitch partnership and stuff, so I've got to get my views up. So that's what I got planned to do today, guys. I know this Wednesday's Coffee Time is going to be quick. Other than that, guys, nothing else is really going on. Pretty much that's it. Just sitting here going to watch a Fly Daily video, and then I am done. I am done. Oh, God, I've still got these bloody bags under my eyes. Anyway, till then, guys, I will see you on Friday's Coffee Time Recovery. Bye. Hey, guys. Friday. 5 past 12 in the afternoon. Coffee Time Cobra. Today is definitely a hard day. I'm in a good mood. Trust me, I am in a bloody good mood. I think I've actually found me a project car that I think I might actually quite enjoy. It's actually it's a little bit, you know, a little bit outside my budget, but I think I can haggle the guy down. And it is an 05, actually it's an 06, 06 Dodge Magnum RT, not the SE, the RT, which means the engine mounts have been reinforced, which means that motor can take turbos. I like turbos. Turbos are like free horsepower. And so yeah, I'm in a good day. Today's a live stream, guys. I will be airbrushing these little buggers. These are my Dark Angels Terminators. As you can see here, I've already done a little bit of work to them, mostly basing and first set of highlights. We will be showing you guys how to take a folk art, an apple barrel, whatever you want to call them, acrylic paint, and turning it into an airbrush paint. So look forward to seeing that as well. More coughing from this guy in the corner because he still refuses to go see a doctor. Even though I'm about to hog tie him to the hood of the damn Jeep and just drive him there. And his missus, of course, in the corner over there laughing at that fault. Anyway, guys, this is Friday's Coffee Time with Cobra. No real bad news, no real nothing to report other than what I've got planned to do today. This video is about to get thrown onto that machine and edited. So, that's pretty much it, guys. So, ciao. I hope you enjoyed the video.